Hello, my friends. Welcome to Forex Weekend. So today is Saturday of 20th of November 2021. Today is our weekly review, weekly forecast. Let's check out the introduction first.
Disclaimer, be advised that I am not a professional financial consultant or advisor. I am sharing this information for education purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, prices, or other information contained on this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video.
Okay, before we start, don't forget, support the channel, subscribe, like and share this with your friend, okay? And watch out my Twitter, ForexWithKS, twitter.com/ForexWithKS, okay? Let's check out the news, see what is going on with the news. So this week, okay, we get US dollar has been strengthening. We got a good retail sales numbers, okay, good retail sales numbers indicating good for US dollar, and we also get good CPI numbers, good CPI numbers for pound, okay, also good for pound. Then we have a not so good CPI number for CAD, okay, these are not probably will weaken the CAD a bit. And other than that, okay, we don't see too many high impact news. We do got retail sales, okay, this to consolidate the on the good CPI numbers, okay. So seems that pound we could be doing better this week. And also we got a CAD, okay, CAD retail sales actually did show improvement, okay. So this is somewhat of contrary result than this one, okay, the CPI numbers are so never mind, we take a look at the chart okay to check whether how is the CAD doing. CAD supposed to be with the weakened CPI number, supposed to be weaker, okay. Later we take a look at the chart. So let's see tomorrow, next week. See what's going on. So Tuesday we got bank holiday for Japan. Monday nothing much. So Tuesday we also got a lot of PMI numbers coming up for Europe. For pound. And for US. So all the PMI numbers are coming out. PMI numbers don't directly have a big impact on the currency. Okay, but the PMI number do indicate how the economy is doing. If the PM number is doing well, is a positive, okay, or meet expectation, that means the economy is doing well. Okay, but so this is on Tuesday. Wednesday we get this NZD official cash rate, so watch out. Wednesday, so watch out. Okay, this could be high volatility. So they expect the official cash rate to go up. Okay, which is indicating a strengthening of NZD, so be careful trading the US, the NZD. So Wednesday we also have these GDP numbers coming for USD. Okay, and we also got this durable goods order, okay, and unemployment claims. Okay, this is not that big impact on the currency. Okay, but we still need to watch these numbers, okay, see whether how's the numbers doing. We also got a PCE price index, okay, for USD on a Wednesday, and University of Michigan consumer sentiment. Okay, so also watch out for this one. Okay, this PCE price index do have some impact on the USD. Okay, so they expect a positive number. So Thursday we got US bank holiday. Okay, so do watch out, and we got FOMC meeting and bank holiday, and we also got ECB President Lagarde speaks. And Friday, we got a government, Bailey speaks, okay, and ECB President Lagarde speaks, so there will be some volatility during this speech. Okay, let's check out the chart. But notably, you need to watch out, okay, the important one, the most important one is the cash rate, of course, for New Zealand dollar, okay, and the GDP, and the durable cost, the durable goods order, and the PCE price index, okay, these are the ones that you need to really watch out for next week. Okay, let's check out the chart. Okay, DXY. So DXY, we getting a push over here, okay, at support one. The price broke through support one, then the price trying to push up again. But now the price reached the previous high over here, right? The previous high at this pin bar, it's not moving up. I'm skeptical that the price can actually move any higher, okay? I'm skeptical. No doubt we have a we could have a 1-2-3 continuation pattern over here, but I'm doubtful that the price can go higher. I'm doubtful doesn't mean it can't, okay? It might still can go higher, but I'm doubtful that it can go higher. We got a double top over here currently. Okay, if you can't see the double top, you look at the 4 hours. Okay, one top, two top, we got double top. Okay, not a complete double top formation, but looks like, okay, we got another top, another resistance over here, so it still can't break through. Let's see the weekly, see how the weekly looks like. Okay, the weekly definitely very strong. Okay, the weekly shows that the bulls are still in control. Okay, so we are still going to buy. Okay, we are still going to buy this. Probably wait for a retracement towards support one first. Let me see here. The retracement to support one already happened. This is a bit tricky to trade, a bit tricky, because I don't think that it can actually go. Okay, we got a channel here, the price is a channel top. Okay, what I want to do for next week, right, I won't be trading here. Here, I will not be trading here. Okay, either the price come back, to support two, okay, a rebound over here, or the price goes above resistance one, retest and resumption. I will only trade these two. Okay, I will not be trading from support one to resistance one. No, I'll not be trading this. Okay, because there's no room to trade, and we got a pin bar over here indicating there is a lot of selling pressure over here. Okay, this one, this pin bar. So I'm not trading this here between S support one and resistance one. S1 and R1, I will not be trading. I will trade the rebound at S2 or a break off above R1. Okay, check out Euro USD. Look at the weekly. Okay, weekly definitely the bears are in control, very strong bearish price action, strong bearish candle. Okay, we got a bearish engulfing candle here. We do have a pin bar here, the price broke through and being pushed back. Okay, so this one similar. Okay, my strategy would be similar on how we're going to trade the DXY. Okay, a retracement towards R3. Okay, possible. I will look for buy opportunity. Okay, or the price break above support one. S1 retest resumption only. I will look for a sell opportunity. Sorry, we are looking for sell opportunity at R3 sell and sell here S1. Okay, so these are the area that we want to look for sell opportunity. Okay, if the price do come to, okay, come back to R2, okay, and it printed a strong pin bar over here, okay, then there is a possible sell opportunity over here. Okay, so there is a three possibility that I'm looking at. Price a bit choppy over here to draw the support resistance, a bit difficult to draw the support resistance. Okay, but our strategy, okay, remain the same. So this one we are still looking for sell opportunity. So pound USD, the idea, we are still buying USD, okay, for the for the next week. So we are looking at the price is retracing towards R1, but did not reach R1. Let's see how strong is the weekly. Okay, weekly we printed pin bar over here. One pin bar, two pin bar. Okay, looks like the bears are still stronger. Okay, the bears are still stronger. So therefore, okay, possible we are looking for this. Okay, wait for the retracement, go deeper to R1 for risk, for sell opportunity. Retracement to R1 for sell opportunity here. Okay, or a 1, 2, 3 continuation. 1, 2, 3 continuation. Okay, a break of this, the nose, the bottom over here. Okay, there is a possible sell towards a support 2 and even possible lower. Even or lower to support 3. One point three five eight six. Let me look at the arrow. Whether I put the arrow right. Okay, the arrow is all correct. Okay, look at USDJPY. USDJPY, we've got a false break over here. So this is not good. This is a false break. Normally after false break, the price will retrace quite far down. Okay, so I expect the price will retrace even lower. Because here there is a false break. So this one, let's look at the weekly. What the weekly telling? What's the weekly telling us? Oh, look at that! A big pin bar, a big bearish pin bar. Looks like the price want to come down. Okay. So this one we are still looking to buy. So our 1, 2, 3 continuation did not work this time. Okay, didn't work. 1, 2, 3 continuation, false break. So looks like the price coming back to support 2. Or possible support 1 or coming back to support 2. Okay, so this one we are looking for sell opportunity. We are looking, the idea is still looking for buy opportunity. Looks like the price is going back to a deeper retracement. So I will look for a excuse me. So I will look for a buy opportunity at support 1. A possible buy opportunity at support 2. Okay, AUD, you see, look at the weekly. Oh, AUD, we see the weekly is extremely strong. Okay, the bears are extremely strong. So we are still looking for sell. Okay, we are looking for sell this. So the price has reached resistance 1, okay, the price has reached resistance 1, so possible we want to look for sell opportunity here and here, okay, resistance 1 or resistance 2. So possible, okay, the price might retrace to resistance 2, a rejection, we want to look for sell, or the price breaks through resistance 1, retest resumption, okay, we want to sell, continue to sell this AUD USD. Look at NZD USD. NZD USD now the price is a bit sideways, so we don't want to trade this sideways price action. You see that we got a railroad track over here. Okay, so we will look for a retracement. towards R1, a rejection, okay, a sell opportunity here. All the price breakthrough support one, retest resumption for a sell opportunity here. Okay, at a support one, S1. USD CAD. So USD CAD, we have a 1-2-3 break here. So continue to hold this towards resistance one. Okay, 1-2-3, 1-2-3 continuation. Okay, so the price we could hold, continue to resistance one. If the price did reverse next week, okay, if it does reverse, come back to support one, then there is a possible sell opportunity over at support one, just in case the price do reverse. So this one, we are still having a trade here. Let me mark this one. This one, no. This one, possible trade next week. USD JPY, not so clear. Pound USD, not so clear. Euro USD, not so clear. Okay, so these two are possible trade. Gold, we are waiting for the retracement. So the retracement definitely is coming. Okay, so once the price comes to support one, rebound, okay, will be our buy opportunity over here at support one. This one, we are not trading the SPI, all sideways, sorry. So we are not trading. Let's take a look at USD CAD weekly. We haven't checked out the weekly candle. Okay, definitely the bulls are strong on USD CAD. Gold, definitely you can see the weekly. Okay, the gold after a breakout now is coming back to retest 1833 S1. Okay, so wait for buy opportunity over there. So let's look at this one. This one definitely a railroad track, right? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 railroad track. So don't trade this. Okay, the DAX. Okay, DAX, look at the weekly first. Oh, we got a pin bar over here. Oh, we got a big pin bar over here. Okay. So DEX probably, this is a bit tricky because we took the 1-2-3 continuation trade over here. It took a 1-2-3 continuation trade over here. So this one, I think we have to put it to break even because of the power of the pin bar. Okay, the power of the pin bar on the weekly. So we possible, right, this trade, right? We put it to break even, okay, just in case the price reverse. So this one, put it to break even, okay. NASDAQ. Well, NASDAQ is very strong. We got 1-2-3 continuation here. Okay, so NASDAQ, 1-2-3 continuation, continue to hold the price, okay. Probably our target will be at here, R2, 1.17218. Okay, continue to hold. Okay, 1-2-3 continuation. Wait, look at the weekly. Yeah, definitely bullish engulfing. Definitely is going up. Looks very strong. Very likely the upwards momentum will continue. Look at Dow Jones. Dow Jones is quite bullish. Bearish. I'm sorry, bearish. Okay. So Dow Jones, wait for the correction, okay? Possible there's a buy opportunity here as support 2. Okay, now the price is at support 1, sorry, 35594, or the price might even go lower to S2, 35122 for a buy opportunity. S&P, okay, S&P also trying to break up, 1-2-3 continuation. Okay, once the price breakthrough resistance 1, there will be a possible opportunity to buy in. Okay, 1-2-3 continuation, so very strong. Okay, once the price breakthrough, 4719, okay, or will be opportunity to buy. Bitcoin, okay, Bitcoin started the correction. Okay, as I said, the correction might even come lower towards 52,000 before. Okay, there is opportunity to rebound. This one continue to hold and wait. Ethereum also, we got a big push yesterday. Bitcoin also, we got a push yesterday, but not as big as Ethereum. Ethereum got a push yesterday. So the next, we got a support over here at 4,000. Okay, so there is a 4,000, big support at 4,000. But there is still a possibility that the price might come back to 3,594. We have to wait and see. Litecoin, Okay, we got supported over here at 208 and 192, and between 192 and 208. Okay, this is a possible support area. Continue to hold. Okay, doesn't look so bad. SRP, okay, I supported at the bottom channel here, so it's still supported. Okay, at $1. Okay, so continue to hold. Doesn't look so bad. Okay, retracement is definitely the part of the game. So don't be caught out by retracement, because this one, right, that's why we are not trading this. Okay, we are holding this because I actually think of Bitcoin as an asset, because Bitcoin, right, is something like it's something that is going to be scarce. Okay, means Bitcoin, right, there's only a certain number of Bitcoin that can be mined, so there's something that in the digital world that there's a limited number of it. Okay, so that's why I said we can hold Bitcoin for long term. Okay, but why don't we buy and hold US dollar? Okay, US dollar is fiat currency. Okay, it's depreciating and it's not scarce. Okay, the US government can print as much as they want, so that's why we are not holding that. Okay, gold, yes, you can hold gold for long term. Okay, as a peg against the inflation, right? But Bitcoin similar. Bitcoin is a digital gold. Okay, that's why we are holding Bitcoin for long term. Okay, so that's it for today. Stay safe from COVID. Don't forget, stay safe from coronavirus. Subscribe, check out my Twitter. Okay, like and follow my Twitter, Forex with KS, and also like and share. Okay, don't forget that. Okay, so see you again on Monday. Monday we will not have any video on Monday, because essentially Monday morning the analysis is exactly the same as today. So we'll continue to talk about it maybe on Tuesday. Okay, on Tuesday, 10 to 11 o'clock Singapore time. So we have video on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Okay, so see you again on Tuesday. Bye bye.